إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، كل ضلالة في النار. إن شاء الله we have the class of tafsir from سورة آل عمران verse 130. That is سورة number 3 verse 130. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تأكلوا الربا أضعافا مضاعفة واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون واتقوا النار التي أعدت للكافرين وأطيعوا الله والرسول لعلكم ترحمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أو يوهو بليف لا تأكلوا إيد نات الربا the ربا don't eat the ربا أو يوهو بليف do not eat and consume the riba. أضعافا مضاعفة, double and multiply. واتقوا الله, but fear Allah, لعلكم تفلحون, that you may be successful. واتقوا النار, and fear the fire, التي أعدت للكافرين, which is prepared for the disbelievers. وأطيعوا الله, and obey Allah, والرسول and the messenger. لعلكم ترحمون, that you may obtain mercy. In these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed the believers. يا أيها الذين آمنوا. O you who believe. Because it is the believer who answered the call of Allah Azza wa Jal and answer the call of his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If truly there is iman, there is faith, there is truly belief in the person, then it is he who answer Allah's call Azza wa Jal. It is he who obey Allah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, what means if you hear Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, he said, listen to it. Listen to it carefully, because it's either good, you're being commanded, or it is evil, you're being warned. Anywhere in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, either Allah is commanding you to do something good, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning against evil. In this ayah, Allah said, La ta'kulu riba. Eat not the riba. Do not eat the riba. Don't eat riba. Don't eat riba. Then Allah mentioned Azza wa Jal, the way the riba is double and multiply. That's the way the riba is. Always is multiply. So much. What riba is? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forbade us to eat riba. He said, La ta'kulu riba, don't eat the riba. Was mandatory on us. If Allah says, as we don't do this, or Allah says, do this, what are we required? What are we required? To learn, to know what is that. This first mandatory. If Allah forbade something, He prohibits something, the first mandatory on me, on every believer, is to know what is that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade such, shirk, forbade riba, forbade such, forbade rich, but people don't know it. How are they going to obey Allah Azza wa Jal? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands such. If you ask many Muslims, they don't know it. Akhi, what's the worst thing Allah warned against? They say shirk. What's shirk? He doesn't know. Shirk is to believe that there is other than Allah who created the universe. That's all what shirk about. So, this is the first mandate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, you believe, la ta'kulu riba. Don't eat riba. Tonight we shouldn't move from there until we know what riba is. Otherwise, what do we benefit from the class? Sheikh Sa'd says, Rahimahullah, قال رحمه الله تعالى في قول الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تأكلوا الربا. تقدم في مقدمة هذا التفسير أن العبد ينبغي له مراعاة الأوامر والنواهي في نفسه وفي غيره، وأن الله تعالى إذا أمره بأمر وجب عليه أولا أن يعرف حده وما هو الذي أمر به ليتمكن بذلك من امتثاله. فإذا عرف ذلك اجتهد واستعان بالله على امتثاله في نفسه وفي غيره بحسب قدرته وإمكانه. وكذلك إذا نهي عن أمر عرف حده وما يدخل فيه وما لا يدخل، ثم اجتهد واستعان بربه في تركه، وأن هذا ينبغي مراعاته في جميع الأوامر الإلهية والنواهي. الشيخ سيد رحمه الله he mentioned in his tafsir, the beginning of the tafsir, that upon the person when it comes to the commandments of Allah and the prohibitions of Allah, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained something, like command to do something, wajaba alayhi, أولاً, the first thing which will be mandatory on the person is أن يعرف حده, to know the had, the reality, the divination of that thing that Allah command. That's the first mandatory. وما هو الذي أمر به, and what is that which he was command? Why you need to know what Allah command you? The Shaykh said, يتمكن بذلك من انتثاله, so he can be acted upon it. So in order to be able to follow the command of Allah Azza wa Jal, if Allah command you something, you should know that thing. You must know it. Otherwise, how you follow it? How you act upon something you have no idea about it? Then when you know it, that's not the goal. That was just the means. The goal is to apply it, to act upon it. Knowledge without action, where is the thamara, where is the fruit? So two mandatory. Number one, knowing what is that. Number two, so you act upon it. فَإِذَا عَرَفَ ذَلِكَ, if he realized that, he came to know it, اجتهد, he struggled. وَاسْتَعَانَ بِاللَّهِ, and he asked help Allah. على امتثاله في نفسه وفي غيره. You ask Allah to aid you to act upon that thing and to call others to it. بحسب قدرته وإمكانه, based on his capability. People are not the same. Some of them are strong, some of them are weak. وكذلك إذا نهي عن أمر, likewise if an issue, a matter is prohibited, عرف حده, he should know the definition of it. He should know what it is at. وما يدخل فيه وما لا يدخل فيه. And what enters into it, what doesn't enter it. What's from it, what's including it, what's not including. ثم اجتهد, then he struggled. واستعان بربه في تركه. And he asked his Lord to help him to avoid. The Shaykh mentioned three things now. Number one, when Allah commands something, know what is that. Number two, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, struggle, strive hard to obey Allah by fulfilling what He commands. Number three, ask Allah help, to help you with the application of what He commands you. On the other hand, likewise, if Allah forbade you something, know what is that. Here tonight we have riba. What riba is? Then after you know it, struggle to avoid riba. And in order to avoid riba, ask Allah to help you. Don't depend on your talent, your sincerity. No, your experience. Rather rely on Allah Azza wa Jal. اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد. The Shaykh said, وأن هذا ينبغي مراعاته في جميع الأوامر الإلهية والنواهي. And this should be considered in all the commands of Allah and all the prohibitions of Allah. This is the general principle. Any command Allah command, any prohibitions Allah made, His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made, this is the manhaj, the methodology of the believer. He should know what is that. He should try to obey Allah by fulfilling what He commands, avoiding what He forbade, and he should ask Allah to help him to do the good and to help him to leave the bad. This is general, everything. Then the Shaykh said, وهذه الآيات الكريمات قد اشتملت على أوامر وخصال من خصال الخير. أمر الله بها وحث على فعلها وأخبر عن جزاء أهلها وعلى نواهيها حث على تركها ولعل الحكمة والله أعلم في إدخال هذه الآيات أثناء قصة أحد أنه قد تقدم أن الله تعالى وعد عباده المؤمنين أنه إذا صبروا واتقوا نصرهم على أعدائهم وخذل الأعداء عنهم كما في قوله تعالى وإن تصبروا وتتقوا لا يضركم كيدهم شيئا. ثم قال بلى إن تصبروا وتتقوا ويأتوكم من فورهم هذا يمددكم ربكم الآيات. فكأن النفوس اشتاقت إلى معرفة خصال التقوى التي يحصل بها النصر والفلاح والسعادة. فذكر الله في هذه الآيات أهم خصال التقوى التي إذا قام العبد بها فقيامه بغيرها من باب أولى وأحرى. ويدل على ما قلنا أن الله ذكر لفظ التقوى في هذه الآيات 3 مرات. مرة مطلقة وهي قوله أعدت للمتقين، ومرتين مقيدتين فقال واتقوا الله واتقوا النار. فقوله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا، كل ما في القرآن من قوله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا افعلوا كذا أو اتركوا كذا يدل على أن الإيمان هو السبب الداعي والموجب لامتثال ذلك الأمر واجتناب ذلك النهي، لأن الإيمان هو تصديق الكامل بما يجب التصديق به المستلزم لأعمال الجوارح. فنهاهم عن أكل الربا أضعاف مضاعفة، وذلك هو ما اعتاده أهل الجاهلية. ومن لا يبالي بالأوامر الشرعية من أنه إذا حل الدين على المعسر ولم يحصل منه شيء قالوا له إما أن تقضي ما عليك من الدين وإما أن تزيد في المدة ويزيد ما في ذمتك، فيضطر الفقير ويستدفع غريمه ويلتزم ذلك اغتناما لراحته الحاضرة، فيزداد بذلك ما في ذمته أضعافا مضاعفة من غير نفع وانتفاع. ففي قوله أضعافا مضاعفة تنبيه على شدة شناعته بكثرته، وتنبيه لحكمة تحريمه، وأن تحريم الربا حكمته أن الله منع منه لما فيه من الظلم، وذلك أن الله أوجب إنذار المعسر وبقاء ما في ذمته من غير زيادة، فإلزامه بما فوق ذلك ظلم متضاعف، فيتعين على المؤمن المتقي تركه وعدم قربانه، لأن تركه من موجبات التقوى، والفلاح متوقف على التقوى. فلهذا قال واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون واتقوا النار التي أعدت للكافرين. الآيات. طيب إن شاء الله. What the riba is? Who can give us the definition of riba? إن شاء الله. In order to avoid it. And in order to avoid it, إن شاء الله to ask Allah to help us to avoid it. نعم أخي. There is 2 kinds of riba. ربا الفضل وربا النسيئة. طيب ما هي ربا الفضل؟ ورزيت ربا الفضل Rebel Father is when you okay, when you okay. Okay. You sell date by date? Okay. Very good. The Rebel Father. How about the Rebel Nasiya? Ahsan. Barakallahu feek. Akhuna Ramzi Ramasai summarized for us. The riba is two type. Is two type. The most famous one, which is the most spread one, the most, even the Jahiliya people used to use it the most. Rather, Ibn Abbas said that that's the only riba existing. And it is the riba, the hikmah, the wisdom behind it. This prohibition is very clear. That one is very clear. The other type, some ulama didn't know even the hikmah was not clear to them. What is that riba, which is widespread everywhere almost today? A'udhu billah, is when somebody takes his loan. He's lended something. He borrow. Then the time, the deadline comes. He doesn't pay it. They increase the money. So for instance, you borrow from someone $1,000. That you will pay after 2 months. The 2 months came. He came to you, give me my $1,000. You said, I don't have it. He said, no. You have one of two. No way out. Either you pay it now, because this is the deadline. Up front now, my $1,000. Otherwise, I increase it. The more you delay, the more the money. Every day, $3. Or 2 more months, $300. Or percentage, 20%, 2%, 1.5. Then it increases. This is riba al-jahiliyyah. Where in the deen of al-Islam, first of all, who borrows something? Is it rich person or poor person? Who the one who need to borrow? Rich person? Naam. The poor person. Barakallahu feek. Okay. So now we have two men. One is poor, one is rich. One, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice him. Allah opened the ways of provision for him. Alhamdulillah, he doesn't need the people. What's upon him is to thank Allah. And from thanking Allah is to help the needy, to help the weak. This is from being grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal. Okay. Now there is a needy person, he couldn't pay the rent. He's in a problem, they put him in a jail. He said, I need you to help me to borrow this $1,000. This rich person, he had an option. He had to give him for the sake of Allah. It's not mandatory on him. He didn't do that. Yes, at least to lend him. To lend him. And to get just what he gave to him. Qardun Hasan. If he's not willing to do that, then he keep his money. It's not mandatory on him to lend him. Don't lend him anything. Now, this one, he's not helping his brother. He's not helping this weak, this poor person who is in need of him. Nor is he just lending him. Nor is he keeping his wealth. He's saying, okay, I pay you, I lend you 1,000, and I want to bring back 1,100, 1,500. So now here you see, the rich person is seeking profit from the poor person. This is not even good in manner-wise. It's not good. It's something the person to shy. How are you seeking profit from poor person? And Allah make you rich. Allah make you the one people need him. Then this weak person, if he borrow money now, is it very possible that the same need he had now, he will have when the deadline comes as well? Because he is needy. So, as he is in need of today, he will be in need of when the deadline comes. If that happens, he is the same situation. He is still in need of your help. What you do now in Islam, if this person is not able, it's not he is negligent, he keeping, he playing game. No, that has different rule. That one is oppressor. He able, but he is not giving it up front. He keeping it. He using it his own. Go on vacations for such place. I don't want to name them. Name it. لا هذا ظلم مطل الغني ظلم. The one who is able to pay back people is right, but doesn't do is a ظالم, is oppressor. But here the issue is someone who is not able. He's not able. He was expecting to get income. He didn't get. Subhanallah. Now, in Islam is فَنَذِرَةٌ إِلَى مَيْسَرَةٌ. Nothing else. You are not able, ya akhi? Yes. Whenever you able, I need my money. Whenever the earliest time you able, I need my money. Other than that, nothing is on you. Even if it takes 50 years. This is in Islam. What's more better is مَنْ يَسَّرَ عَلَى مُعْسِرٍ يَسَّرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Whoever make ease for one hardship, Allah make easy for him. But yes, if you are not that high, good people, barakallahu fihim, who make easy for the people, at least don't ask more than your right. You are allowed. لا تظلمون ولا تظلمون. You are not being oppressed. You are not allowed to oppress. So now, this person, he is increasing the debt on this person. This is a disaster. Whoever knows. Some company or some government agencies, the day you owe them money, the more you take, the more it increases. Sometimes even you can't pay off. You already pay off the money you owe them. And what left is more than what you from beginning. And this person, all his life is stuck. He cannot travel, he cannot get married, he cannot do everything. Can't he move on? Some people, they even own them. The person's car, house, his life. The rest of his life, he cannot even pay it off. Some people, as it happened in some countries like India, and it used to happen at the time, Prophet ﷺ, in Medina, the son, he take what his father owe. His father couldn't pay. Then the son, the offspring, all of them, they are people who are in debt. So, this is not allowed in Islam. Don't increase anything. Just your right. لا تظلم ولا تظلم. Don't oppress, and you shouldn't be oppressed. This is one type of riya. It goes in life now. Life, almost everywhere. But they give it good names. They give it different names. So much names. Yes. The other thing, the second type of riba, as Akhuna mentioned, is riba al-fadl. There are some kinds of goods or wealth, in which if you are trading one another, you switch one another, you're selling you to one another, you have to follow two conditions. For instance, is al-dhahab bil-dhahab. You selling gold for by gold. Or wal-fidda bil-fidda. Silver by silver. والشعير بالشعير والبر بالبر wheat by wheat والشعير بالشعير barley by barley والتمر بالتمر dates by dates والملح بالملح salt by salt these if you are you have a date you want to sell it because you like another kind of the from the date. But you know the dates are different. Some of it, even the color, the taste, the quality, based on the kind of tree, the land, the earth. But in Islam, if you are selling a date and you want to get instead a date, you are not allowed to increase. If it is 1 pound, it must be 1 pound. Regardless the nature of the dates, one is very good quality. New, fresh. One is very old. Not with a good quality. Even people don't like it. You are not allowed. The hikmah, Allahu A'lam. Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam, one of his sahaba brought nice dates. All of it good. Where he brought this date from? Khaybar. He said, from Khaybar. Prophet said, أَكُلُّ تَمَرُ خَيْبَرُ هَكَذَا كَمَا قَالَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ. Is the dates from Khaybar all of it this way? So good, all of it. He said, no, the Messenger of Allah. I had 2 kilogram of such date, and instead, I buy this one kilogram. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, this is the riba. This is the riba. This is the riba. What you could have done was, you had to, right, sell it. Sell it normal way. Get money, get gold, get money. Then whatever money it costs, these two, and يعني, low class dates, buy it now, the money with the new fresh one, whatever it costs, less than kilo, more, doesn't matter. You can do that. But to switch date and date, and one to be two and one to be one, this is the riba. Likewise, the salt, likewise, the barley, the wheat, and some ulama, they say, they generalize. Al-Muhim, this is the hadith mentioned. On the other side is the currency, the money. The gold by gold. Silver by silver. No increasing. Okay. If you switch these things, dates, for instance, salt, 1 pound of date, you can sell 2 pound of salt. But it must be hand by hand right away. You don't delay it. You this is understandable. So salt you can trade with what? With dates more, with barley more, with wheat more. Because it's too different. Even though from the river group, but it's too different genes. You can make it more, but it must be hand by hand. You don't say, Akhi, I need a salt and I have a date. I say, okay, I have a salt, but your date, يعني, I need at least two pounds of salt for your 1 pound of date. You say, it's fine. But I told you I have now only 1 pound of salt. So come back for the other. It's not allowed in Islam. It must be hand by hand. This with the food or this. The money, the same thing. Gold by gold, silver by silver. You can switch. Gold by silver, yes. It can be more. But it must be hand by hand. But gold by gold, no. Silver by silver, no more than. It must be hand by hand, it must be the same. Quantity. Okay? Now, what we understand now is the money. The money is the same. It takes the same rule of the gold and silver, the dollar. Dollar is one kind. It's like a gold. Or like it's like silver. Riyal, the Saudi money, for instance. The junaih. The yank. Any other currency is a different type. You can switch. It can be more. You can trade. Can be more, but it must be hand by hand. You go to the bank. You are at the airport traveling. You have Bangladesh money. What is it? Dhaka. You have Dhaka money. Yes? Taka. Barakallah. You have Taka money. It's Bangladesh money. Okay. Akhun Amir traveled to Bangladesh. He's then at the airport. You exchange. He has a dollar. $100 he has. They say $100 for Taka money is 50 Taka money. It's fine. Because it's different. It can be more. But hand to hand. Right away. But if it is dollar and dollar, it must be the same. It must be the same. Where the ulama, they are asking. They are asking when the government, so the government, they give the salary to the employee, they take from certain bank. Bank al-Riyad, Bank al-Markazi. They take from their salary. But that bank is busy. People have to be in line. So what they do, they go to the other banks, which has less customers, to take their salary. But there, they charge 10 riyal. What they call the surface money. The ulama, they say, is riba. It's riba. Because this one, he take the check. The check is riyal. The check can be dollar. They take the check of, for instance, 1,000 riyal. They giving them 1,000 bills of riyal. The bank take the check and they charge the person 10 riyal. So this person, he pay 1,000, 10 riyal. The bank gave 1,000. The ulama, they say, this is riba. Here you are switching money. And it is the same group. The same, what do you call? Currency. It must be yadan biyad, mithlan bithmithl, sawa'an bisawa. Faman zada aw istazada faqad arba. Well, how many things? So many things. You go to money order, extra money. They give you names. So the riba is these two kinds. One is lending, through lending. This is widespread. Lending houses, you don't pay the rent on time. Even though some ulama, they say the renting, when the person is punished for delaying, paying the rent. Some of them say this is different than lending a money and increasing. Then somebody who rent a house, he didn't pay on time, they charge him penalty fee. Some of them say it is the same. It is the same. Some of them say, no, this is different. Ala kulli hal, don't involve, don't help someone to eat the riba and don't be the one who consume it. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, la'ana Allahu akil ar-riba, sa'udhu billah. May Allah curse the one who consume, the one who eat the riba. وَمُوْكِلَهُ And may Allah curse the one who helped him to eat. Meaning the one who deal with him. You go to a dealer, you get a car, or you buy a house through a mortgage, through riba. The curse of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is on that person, the seller and the buyer. Both. Not only that. وَكَاتِبَيْهِ وَكَاتِبَهُ And the one who writes. وَشَاهِدَيْهِ And the two witnesses. هُمْ سَوَى They are equal. Because وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ Don't help one another on ithm. Now this bunuk is the bank is so widespread in a Muslim land. Maybe no country is free from bank of riba. Bank of riba. Open. Is very clear in Islam. Riba is haram. And this Muslim who is on the front line in the masjid in prayer, he has this bank. Lending believers, taking their wealth, their blood. And the punishment is so severe. Even Prophet he saw one of those being punished in a life, the life in the barzakh, in the grave life. He saw him swimming on a blood, river of blood. And whenever he tried to come out, there is an angel throwing a rock to the mouth of this. He turned him back to where he started from, there is swimming. He does that until the day of judgment. La ilaha. Because he was eating riba, means blood of the people. يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ riba and no barak. Allah takes the blessings from riba. Therefore, those who riba, eat riba, are people who in their heart, Allah wa'alam, how they are in their heart disgrace, how they are humiliated in their heart. La. They destroy, na'am. Na'am kathir. Allahu A'lam, that one, first of all, this is when you give, you taking. Here you are not even taking it. You sending the money to somewhere else. You are not taking back. This picture is somehow is different. Because you, now, here the Prophet says, yadan biyad, hand to hand. You give it, you take it. This surah is not here. You sending money to someone who is somewhere else. And this person is like wakala, somebody who represents you. Ala kul hal, it's another chapter. Babul wakala. Inshallah, tomorrow night we review that issue, inshallah. Remind, you make research on it. Antal masul. Inshallah, yahfadak. Idha su'il, wasail. والمسؤول لا يدري على السائل أن يأتي بالجواب. This is the ruling. If you ask question, and the one you ask he doesn't know, you look for the answer to benefit all of us. نعم أخي حسين. What they do? Yes, here is someone who says he deal with the riba. But he says he doesn't use it for food. Because, you know, if he eats from haram, his dua is not being answered. What he use, he paid to the tax. Yes, the government. He paid to the insurance. He gives the money to the one who collected the tarash. La, ya akhi. Ya akhi. You cannot benefit from haram in any angle. No difference. قاتل الله اليهود. إن الله لما حرم عليهم شحوم الميتة أذابوها ثم باعوها فأكلوا ثمنها. كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Messenger of Allah said, may Allah curse the Jewish. When Allah forbade شحوم الميتة, the fat of the dead, what they did? They cook it. It turned into oil. They sell it, they eat the money. There's no difference between. You eat the fat of the dead And you don't eat it, but you sell it, and you eat the money. What's the difference? Subhanallah. Inna Allah idha harrama shay'an, harrama thamana. If Allah forbade something, He forbade the outcome. And so Allah said, وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Don't help one another on sin. So even if you... نعم أخي. So على كل حال, you find like someone who sell alcohol, he sell khamr. There are some, they sell khamr haram. Why? He says he sell to the kuffar, he doesn't sell to the Muslims. You are not allowed to sell haram to anyone. To anyone. وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Don't help one another on sin and oppression. Don't be a part of it. Don't give haram to anyone. Don't help. Therefore, Prophet he cursed شَارِبَ الْخَمْرِ. The one who drink alcohol. The khamr, the wine. وَعَاصِرَهُ and the one who juice it. وَمُعْتِصِرَهُ and the one who it made that for. وَحَامِلَهُ the one who carry it. All of them. He cursed at least 10 people. All relate to the wine. Because they help one another. If you are not selling to this person, how could he make the haram? If the one who says he doesn't eat the riba, but you're dealing with the one who eat. So the ulama, they say don't involve riba. But if it happened by mistake, they sometimes give you extra money, the bank who deals with it. Here some ulama, they say don't touch it. Don't touch it. Some of them, they say take it from them and yani, don't use it. You get no reward from Allah. Don't ever expect. Just get rid of it. Instead of leaving them and maybe lending another one, and they say, give it to the poor. Don't give it to a masjid. Don't use it. It never goes back to you with any benefit. Don't pay it the rent through to it. No, don't benefit from riba. That's a necessary situation. When it was not your choice, but you to go and to involve. La al-ghayyum. The ulama, they were asked this question, how about the one who involved the riba? He borrowed based on riba, but he believes he is able that he will pay on time. Therefore, he is not paying any riba. What is the ruling in this case? The ulama, they say, entering this contract itself is haram. Whether you pay it or you don't pay it, the contract itself is fasid because you agree on haram. This is one thing. The other thing, who told you will not pay it? You will be able to pay it. Is there anyone who wants to pay riba? Nobody wants to pay riba. Nobody wants. Everyone wants to pay off. But still they don't pay it because what make you need now may make you need it later. So the one who's saying he's able to pay it, هذا سبحان الله. Even you are not, you don't know even you're going to be alive tomorrow. How you know you will pay everything on time? La. So that condition is facet. This condition of you will pay riba, if such happen, don't accept that condition. Find another way. Tawakkal Allah. If life is very tight, no way but haram, look for another land. وَأَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَ. The land of Allah is so wide. Even though sometimes we may think the life is only where we are, but the land of Allah is so large. You leave a land because of you can't obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for sure Allah will make way out for you. Because Allah promised, when you hajir fi sabilillah, yajid fi al-ardi muragaman kathira, wa sa'a. Naam. Someone was raising. Naam akhi. So the 0%. How about if you don't pay on time? It's the same thing. It end up, it goes back. No, it's not. They say 0% with a condition to pay it on time. No, it's the same. The condition of riba, no different to be brought the beginning or to be brought later. Yeah, so even it's oppression them to say, if you pay on time, that's okay. If you don't pay on time, we take your car, whole car. Why are you taking whole car? You shouldn't take whole car. The car should be sold. And then, if remaining, yani is less than the cost of the car, then they only take their right. And the rest will be given to the owner of the car. Yes, if it is the Islamic way is, if for instance a company, they sell to you a car, the deadline come, you don't pay their money, based on the agreement, they have right to sell the car, or you sell the car. They need to get their $10,000, so the car should be sold out. If it costs $15,000, $5,000 is for you. If it costs $10,000, you have nothing on them, they have nothing on you. If it's all $5,000, remaining $5,000 is on you. This is the adara, this is the just. But someone paying whole car, $100, $200 left, something go wrong, they take whole car, which may cost $20,000. Tow it. Yesterday he had something, today he has nothing. He's there at the bus stop. Subhanallah. Subhanakallah wa bihamdika la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.